I'm David Halpin, age 68. I'm a retired orthopedic and trauma surgeon. For the last 6 years, I've been standing up for the Palestinian people in their torment. I started doing that because I was outraged by the bombing of some of the poorest people on this earth in Afghanistan by B-52s from 32,000 feet. That was what galvanized me. And you say, why would I then look at Palestine? Well, Palestine is the hinge of our humanity. It is at the hinge of our humanity. It was in my mind to go back in February, because there are two main projects that our charity is trying to push forwards. Radio Delphine, a cultural and educational radio station, and also a audiology and speech clinic in the south, an outreach clinic, which I want to see much better set up. It was all too sketchy what I was presented with last June. Anyway, when this happened, I felt I needed to be there to be with my brothers and sisters, to offer my expertise as a surgeon and doctor, and also to represent our charity, whose central object of which is to promote the welfare of children. Well, at any better time should you promote the welfare of children than this Hades that has been created. So I knew from being attached rather peripherally to Free Gaza that the boat was going. They were setting it off early from Larnaca. It had been advanced from the 6th, I think, to the 29th. I said, is there a place for me? Yes, we'd be welcome to come. So I took a flight within 24 hours' notice. And in fact, I got to the boat about an hour before it was due to cast off. There was a good master and mate, Englishman and master, good Greek mate, and there were 14 passengers. One was a lovely chap called Sam, who'd been in Guantanamo, courtesy of Mr. George Bush and his cowardly crooks for 6 years. There was an Al Jazeera pair, lovely men. There was a very nice chap from CNN who produced some very good footage which has been broadcast widely, who was sick all the time. There was a wonderful person called Cynthia McKinney, who was a US congresswoman for 5 years, who stood for the presidency this time, and who told me what she'd had to put up with in the way of the most grotesque interference from the pro-Zionist lobbies there, because she speaks for Palestine as well. And there were some other good folk. Anyway, we set off, gunning across the Mediterranean, quite a powerful boat. At 5 o'clock in the morning, when we had already done about three quarters of our passage to Gaza, and when we were about 60 miles off the Israeli coast, I saw some searchlights, and I realized that these were, I knew these would be Israeli gunboats, which you see going up and down the Gazan coast, oppressing the fishermen, sometimes shooting them. And I made that, other people saw them as well, and they're very fast. They can go 40, 45 knots at least. They are very powerful boats, and I say very fast. And they were coming up, going round, falling back astern. They put up some flares, one or two of those. I don't think there were flares, any particular message attached to them. There are, as you know, special colours and sequences for maritime flares, and I'm sure they put up tracer as well, tracer bullets. But that wasn't to us, it was going up in the air like an ellipse. Anyway, after half an hour, the lights went out. They were coming up to us and then going away again. I thought it was trying to intimidate us. There was no conversation with the master, who comes from Portsmouth, Dennis Healy. Anyway, 10 minutes of darkness, and then suddenly, the most almighty crash in the bow of the boat. In fact, two crashes and a third crash, within about a second of each other. And I thought we were just going to evaporate, actually. I thought the boat was breaking apart. It was a hell of a row. The master said, we've been rammed. And I could hear him up the companionway, he shouted that. And I thought we were going to sink, because the bow dipped with the collision, with the ramming. I have to be careful of my words. And I imagined a hole in the bow, And I imagine it's scooping water. We were doing 20 knots down the waves, I understand, from the master. And no one had life belts on. Half the people were asleep. And it then became evident that we weren't sinking. But I thought that we were going to drown. And I had a puffer jacket on. Other people had similar sort of clothing on. And I think a life vest with a puffer jacket in a pretty stiff wind in the dark. I was going to die. And the fact is this: the media went out, there was no reply.
And there had been no communication?
No, no. Contrary to what the Israelis are saying, the captain of whatever boat it was that crashed us, he had his lights off, he could not be seen. We were fully lit, lights in the saloon where we were sitting, puking. And there was also lights in the wheelhouse and all proper navigation lights. He accused us of being involved in terrorist activities. We had 3 tons of cartons on board that had all been checked by the Cypriots. In fact, the Cypriot government had given most of it, unlike our own bloody government, which would give nothing to people over there. The Cypriots had done. He then also talked about subversion. And he also said he was going to shoot the boat. Later on, he did say, "Do we need help?" Well, you don't usually take help from somebody who's put a knife in your guts. So the master, quite rightly, said no, he didn't need help, because we established then that we weren't sinking. It had 8 bilge pumps working. That happens anyway. They were going anyway. And the boat stayed, so we weren't taking water. The Israeli captain told the master to make for Larnaca, or was to turn tail. We're only about 60 miles from Gaza. We were 53 miles off the Israeli coast. That's about 33 miles outside an international limit. But that's irrelevant. You don't ram boats. And you can see that when we in fact told this oppressive creature that had rammed us, or his fellow officer, inverted commas officer, and he said steam back to Larnaca, it wasn't in fact, we're up at this point here, it wasn't that much out of our way to steam towards Lebanon. All right? That's one of the fast patrol boats. I'll describe it. It will do over 45 knots. There's about 3 of them actually. I know, I did actually look this up, I wrote a piece about them. It has where mums are hunting around for a cup full of kerosene to do a bit of cooking in the beach camp, where Ismail Haniyeh lives, the premier, a very good man who I've met twice now. This thing has 10 tons of fuel in its bilge to power its jet boat. It uses jet, it has the water jets to push it along. It has a surf leveling gun on the front, which the computer controls. So they're able, in fact, to shell, as they're doing now, the people on the Gaza coast fairly accurately, because the gun stays dead on its target. So that's one of the patrol boats, and that's one of the said boats. That's probably the gun I'm talking about, actually. I'm not sure. I don't know, but there it is, firing away. Very good at firing stuff. If you go onto Rafa and you look at the cannon pockmarks on the buildings there, the apartment blocks and the houses, and the rifle shots and the shell fire, great holes from the shells, you will count thousands and thousands of pockmarks. This is a hole on the boat. It gives you some idea. I'm sure, in fact, it approached about 45 degrees on the bow side, and the bow of the boat rode up to there, I should think. It shattered this side of the wheelhouse and all the glass. We couldn't go down to the heads for pee because there was glass all over the place. And the master was over this side where the wheel was. We think he might have chosen this side. So it didn't be. I don't know. I think that's a foolish thing. I'm quite certain the intention was to sink us and to drown us. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I hadn't actually discussed that. Why should they want to drown 16 people with David Halpin, with the grandfather, and other people like that? The reason is we were going to speak to Al Jazeera probably. They are in Gaza. They are uploading film up to the satellite. Otherwise, we wouldn't see much of what's going on. They didn't want any more of that. And particularly people who could speak very fluently and tell the story. The second thing is quite important, and that is that they hate people helping Palestinians. They really hate it. They hate it. I've seen it. I've had it addressed to me. Why are you doing this while I've been going through Ben Gurion Airport, Lod Airport? Why are you helping Palestinian children? Yeah, extraordinary question. They resent it. But I think it was that he is a very well-known advocate for justice, actually, Cynthia McKinney, and myself too. On the boat, Cynthia eloquent, symbolic. So she had been very powerful there in Gaza while this hell was brought to them. I wouldn't have been without words either, I can tell you. Who else was there? Well, of course, Al Jazeera they didn't like, but there are other Al Jazeera people anyway. Yes, I wondered, you know, that if we were in the water and surviving for a bit, what they would have done. I think they would have understood. Do you understand me? And, you know, you might have found about two bodies about 3 weeks later, coming up on the shore. But then you have to think of Blair. Blair wasn't on this naval gunboat, deciding suddenly to run us down. He was sitting in Downing Street and before that on in the Azores meeting Aznar and Bush to plan their assault, laying upon Iraq like wolves, as George Galloway said. They were sitting in comfortable surroundings, surrounded by fellow psychopaths like Campbell, planning the destruction of thousands upon thousands of lives and a country and a water system and artifacts of great beauty, you know, from the Sumerian period and Babylonian period. Now, it's important to say that there was no warning, there was no conversation, there was no words exchanged between the master and the Israeli boats, so two of them, before we were rammed. And we were rammed, unlike how CNN have latest spun it, as they say, R-A-M-M-E-D, rammed. There was no conversation, even though the Israelis are claiming that. We were then told to make a course back to Larnaca, although we're only about 56 miles, I think it was, from Gaza. They weren't going to let us go on to Gaza. So the course was changed, we turned tail really, and we were ordered to go back to Larnaca, whatever. This is with a boat that was, you know, badly damaged. How about this for humanity? He did offer help, but when you've been rammed by someone who offers you help, you're not necessarily going to take it, are you? In case that's a coup de grace. And Dennis, in fact, steered pretty well northwards, I think, actually, towards Larnaca. If you look at the map, it's like that. And it was decided slowly that we would, in fact, make for Lebanon, so because we did not have enough fuel to go all the way back to Larnaca. Anyway, the boat was a question. There was a question mark over the boat. So we went in fact, to Tyre. We had a biggish boat, frigate of UNIFIL, it's a United Nations boat, came up, and the Israelis, who were well back at that point, were shouting us. They fell away as this other large boat took us under its wing, and that took us further northwards onto the coast of Lebanon. And then eventually an army, the Lebanon army boat, led us into our berth. And there were lots of fishing boats. they'd heard it on the radio and on the television. There was jubilation, hundreds of people there, mostly men. A lot of people wanted to interview you. And we had actually very interesting 3 days in Lebanon, but I would have wanted it differently. And one reason why I weep at the moment is that although I think I'd find it very difficult in Gaza at the moment with the noise, I hate noise. I feel it's my intention to go there, Tim. And there's murderous people to stop me. And they were going to murder us. There's no question about that. We've analysed it. You don't charge a boat. It was a much stronger boat than they thought. if it was a GRP glass reinforced plastic boat, it would have broken up. It was in fact a marine ply, well made boat actually, it made in Italy, early 70s I think, and it didn't sink, they didn't break it up, it was more elastic, you see. But they did want to sink us.